the people who will be able to confirm that the agenda would have raised then was what was discussed in this meeting. So page number two was the agenda and the program. Of course, we had introduction and the circles which were there, the number of tracks they had. We go to page number three. There were discussions. Of course, we had the director general representative informing the meeting that Kenya is very grateful to the stakeholders and that the board of directors gave a directory to the authority to meet and engage all stakeholders in protecting the road asset and said that SACOs are among the first to be met. He said the final meeting will be with the minister as a continuous engagement. That is the agenda. And after this meeting, we, of course, we want to make this meeting biannual. So each year we expect to have two meetings with stakeholders at a venue agreed, in which case we'll be able to address the progress and also address any arising issues. And along the way, we'll be able to be inviting the key stakeholders, like we did today. So we expect maybe in the next meeting, we would like that the minister be the one to be able to officially open the workshop, just like today we had the DG. We have item 3.7. Participants were asked to look at the draft SACO bill to ensure that once it is accepted by the minister, it will serve them better. We had the NTSA representative telling us about the transporters regulation. 3.8, the DG said that Kenya will make good roads and that stakeholders should comply with all the set rules and regulation to protect the infrastructure. We go to page 4. 4.1, we had the chairman informing the meeting that most of the tracks owned by the members are 2-axle, 3-axle, and 4-axle, but noted that some circles have incorporated 6-axle tracks, which are mostly used to transport transit goods and were not part of the working arrangement. I think this one we have enforced, right? So we all agree that for SACO we go up to 4 axles. The only other consideration which we have seen here is if you have a pulley combination that is transporting building materials, okay? We'll be able to consider that based on the innovation we were told here. So we'll rectify this one to say under consideration of those 3 or 4A trucks, which are pulley trucks, okay? We want to adopt that. Then the operations manager, SGS, gave a brief of the mandate of SGS with respect to the management contract, sensitized the members on the permissible axle limits. We have done that today also. So under 4.4, which is critical, the operations manager told the meeting that as a way of supporting to self-regulate, Kenya proposed to give an allowance of 1 ton on 2-axle trucks from 18 to 19 and 2 tons on 3-axle from 26 to 28 and 4 axles from 30 to 32. This was driven by the fact that most of the members deal in transport of loose construction materials and where there is a challenge in determining the weight from source. So this one brings me to the agenda that Wakaia said. We all don't have a problem with the allowance we have been given on GVW, right? The biggest problem we have is on axles. Are we together on that? So he gave us suggestions that right now we are considering a limit of 10 as we are discussed on an axle. But he said we consider you to an axle limit of 11. Then on item number 5, he said that the additional weights, most of the trucks are now showing a problem of distribution points on the axle. And there was need to review this since most of the damage of the road is on the axles. We were able to do that research of the SACO vehicles, and true, and we agree with the Waka here, for most of the 2 axles and the 3 axles, the variation is up to at most 3 tons. So especially for 2As is where we have a problem. 2As. 3As, the distribution is usually not a problem. Item number 4.6, the participants were informed that benefits will only apply to members whose trucks operate within a class and should have SACO stickers. I think we have reviewed this, and we have said as long as you're in a SACO, you can self-regulate in any weighbridge, okay? The officials were informed that the authority operates an automated system and that in order to avoid audit queries, all members are expected to cooperate by following law and also their respective SACO bylaws. Permits and requirements. That's where now we have to make a resolution today. The senior engineer asked to control told the participants. Operations were informal, but needed to be made formal. For it to be made formal, all members are required to be issued with the exemption permits. The permits will be issued for 6 months and on condition that the application comes from the membership number. And this is part of the agenda that Wakaya set across, and he said that we should make it formal that it is for 6 months. And I think it stems from the fact that most or our sister authorities do not usually recognize the whole asset of SACCO. So they have been using it subjectively. And I think we are agreeable to that with you, because we said as much as it's goodwill, the people who are not in SACCOs are your competitors. And some of them are using these to say that we are applying justice selectively, isn't it? But then we agreed also, because we are given the discretion on the permit, it is within the law now to use that discretion within the legal framework, okay? So it is us who made this suggestion, but there was heated debate at that time. And I'm glad that after a lot of discussions, even you have agreed that you need that permit. We have also said that that permit will be able to empower the SACCO officials on compliance by their members. But the permit will remain the property of the SACCO. Are we getting it? So the application of the permit has to be made through the? Are we agreeable on that? Because if you are agreeable on that, we are basically removed the power now of the SACCO from us to you. And that is as it should be. Okay? So that if you have your own disciplinary issue or compliance issues within your SACCO, then after 6 months, you may refuse to submit this guy's application until he sorts your domestic issues. Agreed? And even on our side, if we find somebody is not compliant excessively, we can always go back and pick our permit and tell you as a SACCO, tell us what you have done with this member before we can renew his. Are you seeing it? The other item we had is that he said the permits will also empower the SACCOs to have control of their members. 5.5, the participants were informed that fees and charges for insurance for permits are based on dimensions and weights, and this is not subject to discussion. I think these ones, you know, most of you have read already now are compliant. That is the good news. On your own volition, I know most of you have already taken the permits, so it's just basically rolling on. And for us, we consider that as a formal now engagement between us and you. The other thing is most officials requested for more time to allow to pass the information and sensitize their members on the importance of obtaining the permit. I'm glad this has been discussed. They requested the authority to give priority to the challenges of operations before issuing permits to the SACCO members. I think what this one we've worked with, and for those who come and apply permits at our office, you realize we have a staff allocated mostly to SACCO applications, right? Once we approve this one, we'll even increase the staffing so that we have a desk specifically assigned to SACCOs on this respect. That's our. And we promise you that permits will always be processed within a day. 5.7, the participants agreed to give more time for consultation and feedback and way forward given in the next meeting scheduled for 3rd November. So you see, we have been faithful to the cause. We said we are going to meet in November, and today we are here. And all this is thanks to you and the people who initiated the first meeting of 9th April. And we always say also that corruption is a two-way traffic. There is the giver and the? Okay? So we made a strong case by saying that most of those problems happen with those guys, first of all, who one, are non-compliant, and two, are not in SACCOs. And why do they do that thing? Why do they do that thing? Intimidation. So number one, they do it because of intimidation. Number two, they do it because of what? Ignorance. Thank you. Ignorance. We need to see the problems and then for us to work out on the solution. Okay? Another issue? Yeah? The nature of the vehicle. Okay, the nature of the vehicle.
What is the standard price? Yeah? 30,000. That is for which offense? Overloading. It doesn't matter whether it's 50 tons or 10 tons.
You know, in our case is about the FSR, the two A.
The two A, yes.
So about you always, sometimes they may assume this truck per volume, you must have about 5 tons. So you are told this is 5 tons. Na mtu akikalculate na kuambia hii, it is over 5 tons. Uh-huh. So it is, there are 30,000. Ama nitue namba ukalipe 200.
It depends with the kind of the lorry that you have.
Yes.
And then second, yes. If it's Kenna, yeah. It's their fines are a bit, okay, it's hard to negotiate with them. So it forces you to pay a lot of money if it's Kenna.
Yeah. Then if it's SGS?
It's a bit cheaper.
Kuna mobile ya Kenha na kuna ile ya SGS.
Yes.
When it comes to SGS,
mm-hmm.
Kuna hii ambao weekly, there is a driver wa hiyo, anachukua 3,000 shillings per truck, per week. Ndiyo wakati wanatokerezea, anakupigia simu.
Wow. That's a good confession, Makumi.
Yeah, that's why,
yes.
Wakati wanatoka kuenda operation,
mm.
Unapata hakuna gari hata moja inashikwa. Kwa sababu gani? The driver of that pickup amepigia watu madereva simu na kuambia kwamba at this time tutakuwa operation on this road. Kwa hivyo muweke magari.
So driver anakula peke yake bila wale wengine kujua.
Sasa sijui lakini I know there is a driver who does that.
Okay, thank you very much.
Mr. Engineer,
yes,
I wish to rectify something.
Yes.
There won't be more client because from here henceforth we are going to comply.
Agreed,
so I
agreed.
Think the whole thing will be
okay. Thank you for the. Can we give him a clap? What he is saying is, after here we should expect that not to happen.
Mine is just a concern until your time.
Yeah.
You see, like us, it's a charcoal, and we are given a movement permit, so we are given it for 3 days. Kwa ukipata au watu kwa barabara, because of the time and the permit, unakumbali kupatiana haraka. Ili uenda kauze because of the permit. Naomba kama the next workshop muta involve watu wa forest, Kenya forest,
okay.
Maybe tuone vile itafanyika.
Okay, thank you. Have these circles helped you in relation to the corruption? Okay, now let's go. How?
Yetu tunashukuru sana. Sababu sasa, tuko na sauti, na tunaweza sema apana. Gari ipelekwe Weybridge, ipimwe, to confirm, na kama iko makosa, tulipe.
Thank you very much. Can we give him a clap? Let's give him a clap.
Since we formed the circles and started incorporating with SGS, we have seen a lot of help. You know, before, we didn't even know the weight that we are supposed to carry. Nowadays, even if you are arrested by the mobile, now you are able to know. And if you are not satisfied, there is somewhere you can go and be addressed and know exactly. So let us say it has helped us so much.
Okay. Mm-hmm. One, that I don't fear meeting with the mobile way bridge. So I usually don't waste time. I'm always in business. Number two, I have interacted with so many people, one with other member circles, and also with Kenha, who we most of the time we feared so much. But right now, we have become friends. Also with the police, because sometimes a policeman would stop you and tell you that you have overloaded. Let me take you to our way bridge, and you could not agree. But right now, I can say for sure, hata namwambia kaa na ufunge mshipi nikupere tuende mpaka kwa Weybridge. So thank you so
thank
much.
You. Can we give him a clap also? Thank you very much.
Since the initiation of SACCOS in the transport industry, it has helped very much. One, we used to have permits from River Road that are no longer in existence. And now my people are doing good business. Two, we, as somebody said, we know our rights, especially people are coming from the coast province, Tana River. We used to be taken as people who are coming from marginalized communities, so we don't know which is which. But with the introduction of the circles and the interaction that we are having, we are becoming knowledgeable, and we know our position. We cannot now be pushed here and there. Thank you.
That is one thing that we want you to know. We are teaching you about your duties, responsibility, and if we wanted to be victimizing, we would have just told you about your duties, responsibilities, and penalties. But we're also telling you about your rights. Because as we told you, we are recognizing that you are a key segment of this economy. And we need to facilitate you. It does not help us to frustrate you in doing your business. Now the question, How much were you doing that permit at River Road that time?
It depended.
No, what was the average price of doing a permit from River Road?
15,000.
And what is the price of doing it in Kenya?
10,000.
So which one was cheaper? Which one was cheaper?
Kenya is cheaper.
Yeah. Are you getting the statement?
Yes.
Some people used to pay up to 40,000 for a permit that is only 5,000 in Kenya because of ignorance.
So right now we are okay because we don't fear the way bridge. Two, when we stopped overloading, we have no problem with tire punctures and bursts. So we are saving in terms of our tires serving us for a longer time. Two, our drivers, you know, now since now we are in touch with the weighbridge, they don't just stop anywhere and threaten the office that now that we have been arrested by the weighbridge, and this is what they want. So you see, the drivers were not paying the weighbridge; they were paying themselves, and you know now they were using our ignorance. And you can imagine somebody whom you have employed being wiser than you.
One, at least for now, we can sleep. Secondly, we have a challenge. After knowing the weight of the truck and the goods that you are supposed to carry, now when you weigh with the weighbridge mobile, when you get an excess, when you want to confirm with the static one, there's a challenge. They refuse to go to the static one.
Before we formed the formation of the circles, we used to instruct our drivers. If they meet those people with mobile web bridges, they just knock them down or they create an accident.